Okay, this is our special pre-Thanksgiving interview with Suzanne Summers. Here we go. And welcome back. It is the Rusty Humphries Show. Our phone number, you don't need it because we're doing a special broadcast. This is our pre-Thanksgiving show. Coming up in a little bit, we'll do more of the history of Thanksgiving. We'll do a little bit of travel tips. But it's always a pleasure to talk with somebody who, I got to be honest, I'm very thankful this Thanksgiving has become a good friend. I would not have thought last year that this person would become a friend. She has. I just am as thrilled as I can be. She's the author of a number of great books. One called Breakthrough, 8 Steps to Wellness, which is a fabulous book. It changed my life. And then a book that is changing lives out there all over the world. It's called Knockout, Interviews with Doctors Who Are Curing Cancer and How to Prevent Getting It in the First Place. Suzanne Summers, welcome back to the Rusty Humphries Show.
Hi, Rusty. How are you?
I am good. Now, we always talk about hormones. We talk about cancer.
Yes.
And I do want to talk about that stuff a little teeny tiny bit, but this is like tomorrow's Thanksgiving.
Right.
And nobody is a better entertainer. And I'm not talking just about singing and dancing because you're that too, but entertaining at home for like Thanksgiving. Do you have any tips? How do you do that? Because you're really good at it.
You give everybody a lot of cocktails.
Just get them liquored up. Woohoo!
Then they think your meal is really great.
No, that's not what you do.
No, Thanksgiving is our biggest holiday of the year because
really?
My husband is Jewish, so Christmas is sort of not his thing, and it can't be Easter or Passover, so we made it Thanksgiving, and he likes it because there's no gifts, and that is one of the nice...
He's kind of cheap, isn't he? No gifts.
You think? That's why I work. But it is a great holiday because... it isn't about gifts. There's no stress with Thanksgiving. So here's what we do. You know, I live in the desert, and I have a compound. And I invite every year all my children and grandchildren come, and there's room for everybody. So in that sense, I am very thankful. My daughter-in-law and I make the whole dinner ourselves, and I love that process of making the stuffing and doing the turkey. By the way, you want to make a great turkey?
Yes.
It might be too late.
No, we got
but
time.
When this airs, but if you go to SuzanneSummers.com, honest to God, I'm not trying to sell you anything, but this is how you make a great turkey. And you buy my Tuscan sea salt rub. So you take your turkey and you smear the whole thing with olive oil, because that's where you get your omega-3 fats, which is really good for you.
Okay.
You put a whole package of the Tuscan sea salt rubs on it. You can't beat it. You wouldn't be able to season it any better than that. Dot it with butter, pour some white wine in the bottom of the pan, and stick it in. And the gravy you're going to have from that will be incredible. And people will say, oh, my God, this is the best turkey I've ever eaten. Just a little. So I digress there.
Okay, now if they can't, you know, it is probably too late to go to SuzanneSummers.com, but is there a special thing in the Tuscan sea salt? Just any kind of sea salt would work? I mean, special?
Well, sea salt tastes so much better than table salt. And you know what table salt is? Table salt is sea salt with all the good stuff taken out of it. So all you're left with is the sodium chloride, which is the dangerous part.
Okay.
But we need a teaspoon of sea salt every day. It's loaded with minerals, and everybody's mineral deficient. And you get achy joints, and your hair's not looking so good, and your skin's not looking so good. You need minerals. So all the minerals are in the sea salt, but the smart salt makers learn to take those minerals out and sell them to the vitamin companies, and then we pay more for the vitamins.
Oh,
I could go on and on. Okay, so olive oil, put sea salt all over it, put sage, put rosemary, thyme, some poultry seasoning, which has some in there, and then dot it with butter, and then put it in the bottom of the pan. There are a few more things in my Tuscan. I just can't remember right now, but that'll make you a great turkey also.
And then I was talking with one of my producers who used to run Casey Masterpiece Barbecue. I don't know if you're familiar with that sauce.
No.
But it's one of the most famous barbecue sauces, and his theory is most people cook the turkey slow and it dries out. What he does is very hot and fast. How do you like it?
Hot and fast. Just the way I like to live my life, Rusty. Hot and fast.
Suzanne Summers. Woohoo! No, I mean, he's like at 450, I think, for 2 hours, something like that. Is that?
You know what? That's a good idea. I've deep fried them, which I think is incredible. It's dangerous, but I do it outside. You know,
although the peanut oil, that's not good, right?
The deep fry.
Yeah.
Well. once a year. I never eat fried food, and it's all fresh peanut oil that I put in there, and it tastes really good. That's one way to do it.
Right.
But and I inject it then with all my herbs and spices and butter. I take a syringe and I inject it into the skin of the turkey so that the turkey breast especially is all loaded with flavor.
The other thing that's special to the Suzanne Summers house is also it gets 14 cc's of human growth hormone, which really just is a little bit of a bonus for everybody.
Yeah, everybody wants to work out after dinner.
There's no sleeping on the couch in Suzanne Summers' house.
But I do have my organic garden.
Mm-hmm.
And like in Alice in Wonderland, I take all the little children, we take baskets, and we skip down the hill, like in a movie. And we cut, right now, all my cauliflowers are in full bloom, and the broccoli is in full bloom. And you know, there's broccoli, and then there's broccoli that you just cut from your garden and bring it upstairs and cook it. It's unbelievable, and the kids love it like that because they picked it, and they feel like they have a piece in it. So I just make this a major family thing. And what we do when we sit down, and Barry Manilow has been coming to my Thanksgiving dinner now for, I don't know, 25 years.
When do I get to meet Barry Manilow?
That's a little, I'm holding him back in my back pocket.
I know, because you think that we're going to fight. You think if I
well,
come to the table...
Well, you will fight politically.
I won't do that. I'm a fan.
Okay.
We'll sing around
and say...
You
just have to keep your politics to yourself.
Of course.
Which will be hard.
You know I go into geek mode.
I know.
I'll go into geek mode.
I don't talk politics with him.
No, you can't. And,
no.
And people say that. I get that every once in a while. I don't know if you do. Yeah, that's Suzanne Summers. Why do you have her on the show? She's a liberal. She's friends with Barry Manilow. They don't talk politics.
No, we don't talk politics.
I'm not a liberal. And you can have liberal friends. It's okay. You just don't have to believe everything they say.
Right, and vice versa.
Yeah.
But I am not a liberal.
Shh.
I'm not a Hollywood liberal. We just need to establish that.
Is that okay to say that now?
That is okay. I just don't go out and talk about my liberalism because I have such passion for my health message. Mm-hmm. And I'm the only one out there with this that has a loud voice with the health message. And people are so sick. You know, I just had this cruise, the Suzanne cruise. We cruised to Jamaica and the Grand Caymans.
You'll sell anything, won't you? Pretty soon we've got coming up the Suzanne Summers deep fryer. It's going to be great.
I do have a deep fryer. I do. Hey, they fired me from Three's Company. I had to figure out how to make a living.
Mama
got I did okay.
I did okay.
Anyway, on this health cruise,
yeah.
I had Jonathan Wright, and I had...
who I'm having dinner with this week.
Who you're having dinner with, yeah. Dr. Jonathan Wright. I had Dr. Robin Smith of the Stem Cell, NeoStem Company, who I banked my stem cells with. I had David Schmidt of the LifeWave patches, you know, because I believe in those nanotechnology patches.
Yeah.
And they came on and they gave guest lectures, and I gave guest lectures, and I gave a concert, and they came, 2,000 people came to all those lectures, they took notes, and I realized people want to be well, and they're not getting great information. So that's why I don't talk my politics, because I trust that the Hughes and the O'Reillys and mainly the Hannitys and the Mark Levins, that you're out there, you know, doing that important work right now.
So, in other words, you're thankful for talk radio.
I am thankful, and I will fight to the death to maintain it. If they try to change that, that's where you'll hear me out there. This is America.
They started a new thing that starts on next week. I just found out that every time I mention any kind of sponsor, I've got to stop.
Why?
And say, and by the way, this is being brought to you by, this is sponsored. The FTC, the laws have been changed. And if I don't do it right, and if I just make a mistake, I forget. $10,000 fine.
No.
I just found out yesterday.
No.
Yes.
What is that? What is behind that rule? What are they trying to do?
I don't know. And the other thing is it's very narrowly focused at certain parts of the media, specifically like talk radio.
Huh. Conservative talk radio.
Yeah. I think what it is, it's the first volley into the fairness doctrine. Let's go after
this
the advertisers
so
first. Yeah.
This just frightens me so much. Well, I'll tell you what frightens me also in my world is a difficulty in getting information out about in my new book, Doctors Who Are Curing Cancer.
Hold a second. Let's take a break. When we come back, because it's the day before Thanksgiving, we're very thankful for our friend Suzanne Summers and thankful for the lives that she's about to save with this book called Knockout. Let's talk about that book next. Don't you dare go anywhere. We'll be right back with our good pal Suzanne Summers here on the Rusty Humphries Show. Welcome back. It is the Rusty Humphries Show. It is our pre-Thanksgiving show. Tomorrow, Thanksgiving, we will be running our very special Christmas Carol radio show starring your friend Rusty Humphries. That'll be tomorrow night here on the Rusty Humphries Show. Same time, same place. My good friend Suzanne Summers here, who I'm very thankful for this Thanksgiving. Her new book is called Knockout, Interviews with Doctors Who Are Curing Cancer. Suzanne, you are really having a tough time out there with people giving you a fair shake on this book, aren't you?
Well, you know, the pros are so pro.
Okay.
And they're saying, good for you, somebody has to say this, get that information out there. Of course, cancer is manageable, cancer is curable in some cases. There are other options to treating cancer, and I've written about all of that in Knockout, these incredible doctors. But you saw when I was on Larry King, they bring in the opposition. They brought in this Dr. Otis Brawley from the American Cancer Society, head of. Now, I Google everybody before I'm going to be on television with them. Do you know that most of the money that the American Cancer Society brings in goes for marketing, for raising more money? So they and then there's overhead, and then there's their cushy offices. And what do you think is left for cancer research? Why do you think we're not ahead in cancer? Anyway, every time I have Google myself, and this Dr. Brawley is constantly talking about how the information I'm putting out there is keeping people from getting the treatment they really need. And as I said to him, do they really need it? If you don't have a cure for cancer, after all your billions, then what treatment are you talking about that they really need? Chemotherapy, which in most cases, other than three specific kinds of cancer, doesn't work. It only works for testicular, childhood leukemia, some lymphomas, including non-Hodgkin's. After that, zip. And I talked to, you know,
but every doctor says that you come in for the cancer and they say, I'm sorry to tell you this, you've got cancer. We got to get you in for a chemo in a surgery right now.
That's what happened to me in November. They wanted to start me on chemo throughout my entire body that day. If I had been another kind of patient and they scared me the way they scared me, saying I had cancer everywhere in my body, I would have taken it. I would be dead now. We wouldn't be talking. So I'm just trying to empower myself and empower my readers. But it's an interesting phenomena. You would think if you were the head of the American Cancer Society that all you'd want to do is find the cure. And when I present them with people who are onto something like Dr. Brzezinski, Dr. Forsyth, Dr. Gonzalez, and I said to them and Larry King, why won't you just talk to these people? Why won't you go down to the Brzezinski Clinic and see what he's doing? What is this man doing that he has a 60% success rate in compliance with the FDA for the worst kind of brain tumors? Why won't you even talk to him? Instead, one of the doctors who was on with me has a stack of papers. I'm reading these papers, and Dr. Brzezinski's protocol is absolutely ineffective. You know, and I sat there and I thought, Larry wouldn't let me talk, and I thought, you're saying that because you are a skilled surgeon, and your forte is removing brain tumors. He has very delicate hands, and he's the best. Dr. Keith Black, the best at removing the tumors. But then after he gets the tumor out, he's got to put that patient into harsh radiation and chemotherapy, and his outcome of mortality is dismal. And so he's sitting across from Dr. Brzezinski, who is curing brain tumors without even removing the tumor with no surgery, just by giving anti-neoplastins, and he wanted to discredit that. And I thought, it's all wrong. If I was in the cancer business and my success was as dismal as it is today, I would be looking to every nook and cranny. So,
well, it makes sense to me. And I'll tell you something else. I was very offended, and I don't get offended very easily, but I was very offended with Ann Curry's attack on you on the Today Show. Well,
yes.
You know, none of these doctors have had legal problems. And, you know, I wanted to reach through the TV and grab her by the neck and go, gee, Ann, I can't wait. I sure hope that you don't ever get wrongly accused of something.
Absolutely. Here she is putting down Dr. Forsyth. They came.
The nicest guy in the world.
You can indict a ham sandwich.
Right.
You know, and all of my doctors were acquitted. It's just that they're trying to shut them up. Now, Dr. Forsyth, he's a friend of yours and a friend of mine. Really interesting doctor. If you go to him and you've got a stage 3 or stage 4 cancer, and he first says to you, I'm required by law, here's what I can give you: surgery, radiation, chemotherapy, and whatever aftercare drug your cancer calls for. Most of his patients say, I don't want that. Then he writes down on the chart, patient refused standard of care, because he's also got his naturopathic and homeopathic licenses,
right,
as well as being a Western oncologist. He takes their blood, sends it off to Germany to do a chemosensitivity test. I mean, why isn't everybody getting a chemosensitivity test? If you're going to throw chemo at people, let's not do it like a dartboard and keep your fingers crossed. Let's see if there's a fit. While that's happening, he builds up the patient's body with nutrients and IV nutrients and glutathione and vitamin C. By the time the fit comes back, if there is one, he can give them the lowest dose of chemo, which is the exact fit already proved in a petri dish for their cancer, into a very strong body, and they do very, very well. Nobody's got 100% because cancer is its own strange right. animal, but much higher success rates than the ones out there shoving chemo at everybody.
Well, and the other thing with Dr. Forsythe in particular is, do you think maybe it was a coincidence that his wife at the time was the head of the Republican Party of the state of Nevada
right, right.
and was thinking about running for Senate in Nevada? Right. And who's in the Senate from Nevada?
Right.
I'm sure it's just a coincidence.
Harry Weed.
Yeah, I'm sure it's just a coincidence.
He looks like a weed.
You know, and they play that dirty. And what they did is they tried to destroy this man's credibility. And all these doctors of yours, every single one of those doctors that you talked to who had problems with the law, not only went back and fought the government, they beat the government. And then on top of that, they're the ones that write the protocol for the government to follow.
Right, right. So. There's something wrong. There's just something going wrong in pretty much every facet of, our government right now and medicine right now. It's very disillusioning. And when you're out there as a messenger, as you are and I am, you got to expect they're going to come after you. But somebody's got to, kick and scream. So that's why I stay focused on the medical, because you're out there doing the political. The country needs us. They really do.
Well, you're doing a heck of a job, and we make quite a team. And
we do.
I'll take credit for that. Breakthrough, by the way.
I want to tell you about one other thing of my Thanksgiving that
yes,
we do.
Yes, please.
We go around the table from the littlest one to the oldest one, and each person talks about why they are thankful. And it's very interesting what comes out at that table. There's 27 of us sit around that table, and it's always very emotional, very insightful, where the kids are coming from, how they appreciate things that they never say. And it turns it into not only a great family experience, but something spiritual about it. It's very enriching for all of us. And, these are very challenging times right now in the world, and it's the first time in my whole life that I look to the future and I don't know what it's going to bring. But all I know is that America is the best idea anyone has ever had. And that's why you're out there fighting so hard that they don't screw it up. And I applaud you.
Suzanne, you're a great woman and a good friend, and I thank you so much. By the way, Breakthrough, everybody, is now in paperback. I would suggest you go get it. It is a it literally changed my life. I've given it to almost all of my friends. I'm going to buy another copy for my brother today. Knockout is brand new. It is number one in the books on the
yep.
charts already. Number
That's
one.
I've been staying up there for 5 weeks. So it means that people want to know.
Well, yes. And they should. And yeah. If you've ever had anybody that's got cancer, you've got cancer, hey, it may not cure everything, but it may give you an idea. It may give you some hope for some change.
Right.
There's some real hope and change.
Yeah, real hope and change.
Called Knockout, Interviews with Doctors Who Are Curing Cancer, How to Prevent Getting It in the First Place. Suzanne Summers, I love you,
Rusty Humphries.
I love you, too. And thank you so much for everything. And another year with you and me, I hope.
You and me, babe.
All right, that's Suzanne Summers. Coming up in a minute, we've got a lot of things coming up, including the very first, well, before Thanksgiving, what was it like, the history of Thanksgiving with Bert Folsom, and we'll talk a little bit about travel, all in our special pre-Thanksgiving show. Suzanne Summers, thank you. We'll take a quick break and be right back here on the Rusty Humphries Show.
Well, that was nice.
Yeah, you're so good.